السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters, 3 weeks ago the topic was about the hadith الدين النصيحة. Religion is sincere advice. It is to show sincere goodwill towards the one you are advising. And part of an-nasiha, part of showing sincere goodwill, is an-nasihatu lillahi ta'ala. And that is to believe in Allah, bil-imani bih, wa ta'zimihi subhanahu wa ta'ala. By believing in Allah and glorifying and aggrandizing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we spoke that the way to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to reflect upon His signs that He revealed, that is the Quran, and the signs that He created within the universe. We spoke about Ayatul Kursi, the greatest ayah in the Quran, giving the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, showing His glory and greatness. And then we spoke about the verses from Surah Ali Imran, calling the believers to reflect upon the creation of the night and day and the alternation of the night and day and the whole universe, the earth and the sky and so on, so forth. Today, along the same line, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ And to yourselves, within yourselves, don't you see? Don't you see within yourselves? Meaning, look at you yourself, the creation of the human himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ. We created the human from an extract of clay. Extract of clay. ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ. Then we made him a sperm into a place that is completely safe and secure. ثُمَّ خَلَقْنَا النُطْفَةَ عَلَقَةً. Then we made the sperm into a blood clot. فَخَلَقْنَا الْعَلَقَةَ مُضْغَةً. Then we made the blood clot into a piece of meat, a lump of meat that is as if a piece that is chewed up. فخلقنا المضغة عظاما. Then we created that lump of meat that is like chewed up, a piece of meat. We made it into bones. فكسونا العظام لحما. Then we covered the bones, we clothed the bones with flesh. ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر. Then we made him into another creation, a different creation. فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. All glory, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessed. He is the best of the creators. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says then after that, this is in Surah Al-Mu'minun verses 12 to 16. ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون. Then surely you are going to be after that dying. ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون. Then you surely are going to be on the day of judgment resurrected. The point is, تفكر أيها الإنسان في نفسك. Reflect, O human, within yourself. أين كنت? Where were you before? And كيف جئت? How did you come to this world? وَمِمَّ خُلِقْتَ and from what were you created? The human, if he thinks and reflects about himself, as the scholars say, الإنسان إذا تفكر بعقله في نفسه رآها مدبرة. You will find if you think with your mind, you think about yourself, you find that you are actually managed. على أحوال شتى مصرفة. You are directed into many different stages. And the stages are mentioned before. نطفة, علقة, مضغة, لحم, عظام. Those stages of creation. So if you reflect upon that, يعلم الإنسان أنه لم ينقل نفسه من حال النقص إلى حال الكمال. If you reflect upon that, you surely know that you did not develop yourself. You were not the one who brought up yourself from that stage of being deficient to a stage of being a perfect and complete human being. You cannot do that yourself now. Now you are a complete, perfect human. Can you change anything within yourself? Can you add a body part? Can you develop or improve within yourself any piece of your body, even the smallest? لا تستطيع أن تفعل شيء لنفسك الآن. لا تستطيع أن تطورها. انتهى خلقك وكمل. Then if you know that you cannot do anything now, you know that when you were much, much weaker, لما كنت أضعف وأنقص بكثير, you couldn't have done that. لم تكن تستطيع أن تفعل ذلك. You see yourself, يرى نفسه شابا, ثم كهلا, ثم شيخا. You see yourself being young and youthful. Then somewhat middle-aged, closer to the older age. Then you become old and senile. You did not move yourself. You did not shift yourself through these stages. You do not choose for yourself these stages. لا تختار لنفسك هذه الأحوال. And كما قالوا ولا في وسعه أن يزايل حال المشيب ويراجع قوة الشباب. It is not within your means and ability to remove these gray hairs that came about and go back to being full of youth. فيعلم بذلك أنه ليس هو الذي فعل تلك الأفعال بنفسه. You know through this that you were not the one who did all of these things to yourself. That you have a creator who created you. لك صانع صنعك وناقلا نقله من حال إلى حال. There is someone who is shifting you from one condition, one stage to another. Otherwise, you wouldn't be shifting without someone looking after you. لا تنتقل بغير ناقل. قال بعض الحكماء إن كل شيء في العالم الكبير له نظير في العالم الصغير الذي هو بدن الإنسان. Some wise people, they said that everything you see in this big universe around you, it has something resembling it in this smaller world of you, yourself, the human. قال الله تعالى وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون سورة الذاريات آية number 21 within yourself and to yourself. Don't you see? They said السمع والبصر منها بمنزلة الشمس والقمر في إدراك المدركات بها. Reflecting on this wise person, he said, and this is being quoted from the tafsir of Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi عليه رحمة الله. He said that hearing and seeing is like the sun and the moon in terms of being able to see things through them, to comprehend and see things through them. أعضاؤه تصير عند البلا ترابا من جنس الأرض. Your body parts, they will end up being dust, the same as the dust of the earth. من جنس الماء, from the water that is found in the universe, العرق وسائر رطوبات البدن. You find within yourself, within your body, the sweat and the different moistures in the body. من جنس الهواء فيه الروح والنفس. From the type of air that you see in the universe, you have the soul and you have the what the soul that is within you that you breathe. من جنس النار فيه المرة الصفراء. From the same type as the fire that is in the universe, you find the gallbladder or this liquid that is gathered together from the liver. It goes into this little bag in you. عروقه بمنزلة الأنهار في الأرض. The veins and the arteries in your body, they resemble those streams and rivers that are found on the earth. كبده بمنزلة العيون التي تستمد منها الأنهار لأن العروق تستمد من الكبد. He said that the liver is like the springs of water that you see on earth, the springs that is providing the water for the rivers. Likewise, the kabid, it spreads into the liquids into the body. مثانته بمنزلة البحر لانصباب ما في أوعية البدن إليها كما تنصب الأنهار إلى البحر. Your bladder, the place where the urine is collected, this is like resembles the sea. Resembles the sea. Because all the liquids will go there in the end in your body. Like the rivers, they will end up pouring into the seas. عظامه بمنزلة الجبال. Your bones, they are resembling the mountains التي هي أوتاد الأرض, which are the sticks holding the earth. أعضاؤه كالأشجار. Your body parts, they're like the trees. فكما أن لكل شجرة ورقا وثمرا فلكل عضو فعل وأثر. As the trees have the leaves and fruits or crops, then every body part that you have, it has an action and it has something that is produced through it. الشعر على البدن بمنزلة النبات والحشيش في الأرض. The hair on your body resembles the grass that is and the plants that is on the earth. Then الإنسان يحكي بلسانه كل صوت حيوان ويحاكي بأعضائه صنع كل حيوان. Then with your tongue and with your body part, you can mimic and you can imitate the sound and the action of any other animal that is on earth. فهو العالم الصغير مع العالم الكبير. So you are the smaller universe alongside with this big universe. مخلوق محدث لصانع واحد لا إله إلا هو. You are a created being created by one creator. There is no true God except He. This is why you look into the tafsir وفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون. قال قتادة, if you reflect over yourself, You know that you are created to worship Allah. من تفكر في نفسه علم أنه خلق ليعبد الله. And there are many other statements from the scholars of the tafsir regarding this, asking us to reflect over many, many things. After you reflect over yourself, you reach a conclusion. You reach a conclusion that you eat and drink, for instance, some of the statements that they said. You eat and drink from one place, but then you defecate from two. If you drink milk, then it will come out from the two places. You are created within yourself. You reflect, one scholar said, في حياتكم وموتكم. You're living and you're dying. Reflect on that. وفيما يدخل ويخرج من طعامكم. What goes in and what comes out of your food. قال الحسن regarding this, في الهرم بعد الشباب والضعف بعد القوة والشيب بعد السواد. Reflect on the reaching the old and senile age after being a youth. Being weak after you were strong. And in the gray hairs after having black hairs. So you reflect over all of that. All of these will lead you to know that there is a creator. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you. This will lead you, this thinking and reflection about your own self within your body, where you came, where you are going to, what is the end. This will lead you to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and will lead you to glorify Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why someone came to Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu wa ardahu fi al-Jannah, as the Imam al-Alusi in his tafsir Ruh al-Bayan mentioned this, that someone came wanting to argue with Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu. He was saying, I'm going to ask you a question. He said to him, سَلْ تَفَقُّهًا وَلَا تَسْأَلْ تَعَنُّتًا. Ask in order to learn, not in order to make things difficult. And he asked him, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ رَبَّكَ. Have you seen your Lord? He said, لَمْ تَرَهُ الْعُيُونُ بِمَشَاهِدِ الْعِيَانِ وَلَكِنْ رَأَتْهُ الْقُلُوبِ بِحَقِيقَةِ الْإِيمَانِ. As for the eyes, they don't see him. But then, as for the highest, for the hearts, they do see him with the reality of faith. And he mentioned a line of poetry which mentions the cure to those who are always in doubt about the universe, about the creator, about the end, life and death, and the end, paradise and the hellfire. He said two lines of poetry saying, دواءك فيك وما تبصر وداءك منك وما تشعر. He says your cure lies within you. It is within you, but you do not see it. يعني reflect over yourself and you will see this. The cure to this confusion, doubts, the cure is within you, but you do not see. وداءك منك وما تشعر. The disease is actually from you, but you just don't feel it. Those doubts, misconceptions, and confusion, it's coming from you, but you do not feel that. And the cure is within you, but you do not see it. وَتَزْعُمُ أَنَّكَ جِرْمٌ صَغِيرٌ وَفِيكَ انْطَوَى الْعَالَمُ الْأَكْبَرُ. You claim, O human, that you are just a little thing, a little body, a small body in this universe, while within you is included this great universe. This great universe is actually, there is a small sample of it within you, yourself, if you can reflect and if you can see the reflection and the seeing that will lead you to believe. If you think about you, yourself, you think about you, the qualities and the attributes that Allah created for you, you will know how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your creator, is, and how great He is in all the things that He has done for you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم، إنك حميد مجيد. Dear brothers and sisters, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, he mentions in a hadith that is a hadith Qudsi, a statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reporting to us, and this statement is other than Al-Quran Al-Kareem. And in this statement, Allah talks about the son of Adam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, fashioned, balanced, brought into existence, but then this human becomes someone who is arrogant and who is turning away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This authentic hadith from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it says, يقول الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يبن آدم, O son of Adam, أنا تعجزني وقد خلقتك من مثل هذه. How is it that you are going to render me incapable? How is it that you are going to run away from me, while I have created you from the likeness of this? This, yani the sperm, this little thing, this little piece, droplet of liquid, of fluid. حتى إذا سويتك وعدلتك مشيت بين بردتين. Up until I have created you, fashioned and balanced you, you walked into two pieces of garments. وللأرض منك وإيد, while the earth, the land, is complaining from you. فجمعت ومنعت. Then you gathered, accumulated the wealth, the money, and منعت, and you withheld this money. You did not spend it in the way of Allah. حتى إذا بلغت التراقي قلت أتصدق. Up until the soul reached the throat, about to come out. Then you say, I will spend, I will donate. وَأَنَّ أَوَانُ الصَّدَقَةِ. How is it now? How can it be now the time of donating? This is the reality of the human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, is the provider, is the sustainer, is the one who fashioned, is the one who brought into existence, yet the human turns away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then we know that the end is either to a paradise or to the fire. It is mentioned from Al-Imam Al-Shafi'i alayhi rahmatullah that he used to say, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, إليك إله الخلق أرفع رغبتي وإن كنت يا ذا المن والجود مجرما. To you, O God of the creation, I raise up my request. Even though, O generous one, I am a sinner. ولما قسى قلبي وضاقت مذاهبي جعلت الرجاء مني لعفوك سلما. When my heart became hardened, the means, the ways and means for me became very narrowed down, very much restricted. I made hope from me to your pardon. I made it like the hope is like a ladder to your pardon and forgiveness. تعظمني ذنبي فلما قرنته بعفوك ربي كان عفوك أعظم. My sin, I looked at it, it is so big and so large. However, when I compared it to your pardon, to your forgiveness, your pardon and forgiveness was far, far greater. وما زلت ذا عفو عن الذنب لم تزل تجود وتعفو منة وتكرما. You continue to be one who forgives and pardons the sins. You continue to be generous. You continue to pardon out of gracefulness from you. out of grace and out of mercy, out of bountifulness that you show. ولولاك لم يصمد بإبليس عابد فكيف وقد أغوى صفيك آدم. Were it not for you, then no one can stand against Iblis, the Shaytan. How could he be when he was able to misguide your chosen one, Adam, عليه الصلاة والسلام. فيا ليت شعري هل أصير لجنة فأهنى وإما للسعير فأندما. I wonder, am I going to end up in paradise? Then I become comfortable. Or is it that I am going to end up in the fire? Then I will regret. This is the point. The reflection over all of this should lead us to look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the eye of glorification. And then look at ourselves and see how small and despicable we are in front of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. How graceful and generous He is, and how much we are turning away from Him, and how much disobedient we are. This feeling of aggrandizing and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and looking down upon ourselves is what will bring us back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will make us return to Him with asking Him forgiveness, believing in Him, glorifying Him, and asking Him for His forgiveness. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit all of us from what we heard, to make us from a people who listen to a statement and follow the best of it. Allahumma inna nas'aluka min khayri ma sa'alaka minhu 'abduka nabiyyuka Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa na'udhu bika min sharri ma sta'adha bika minhu 'abduka wa nabiyyuka Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا. اللهم أعنا ولا تعن علينا، وانصرنا ولا تنصر علينا، وامكر لنا ولا تمكر علينا، واهدنا ويسر الهدى إلينا، وانصرنا على من بغى علينا. اللهم اجعلنا لك ذكارين، لك شكارين، لك رهابين، لك مطواعين، لك مخبتين، إليك أواهين منيبين. ربنا تقبل توبتنا، واغسل حوبتنا، وأجب دعوتنا، وثبت حجتنا، واهد قلوبنا، وسدد ألسنتنا، واسلل سخيمة صدورنا. اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأخلاق والأعمال، لا يهدي لأحسنها إلا أنت، واصرف عنا سيء الأخلاق والأعمال، لا يصرف عنا سيئها إلا أنت. اللهم ارحم المستضعفين من المؤمنين، اللهم أدخلهم مدخل صدق وأخرجهم مخرج صدق، واجعل لهم من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا. اللهم عليك بعدوك وعدوهم، اللهم أحصهم عددا واقتلهم بددا ولا تغادر منهم أحدا. اللهم اجعل تدبيرهم تدميرهم. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا، وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.